So let's see if you can talk to him.
It's a hard act to follow.
What's
Hi, Mr.
Your name?
President. I'm Ruchi. I'm from San Jose, California.
What year in school, Ruchi?
I'm a senior.
Fantastic. You know where you're going to go next year?
Not yet. College decisions are coming out soon.
All right.
So I'm still waiting.
I suspect you'll do okay. So what have you been working on?
I developed a nanotechnology-based biosensor for cardiac health diagnostics. So cardiac arrest is actually the leading cause of death in the world. It causes approximately one-third of the deaths.
Right.
And current methods for detecting cardiac arrest are long, they're expensive, they're invasive. So I wanted to develop a device that was very inexpensive, minimally invasive, and very kind of sensitive. So this is actually what it looks like. So it's a silicon wafer-based device. It's based in nanotechnology, so one drop of blood would give me an electrochemical readout based on which I can tell you what a certain protein concentration in your bloodstream is. And based on that, I can tell you your risk for cardiac arrest.
So this protein in the bloodstream there's a high correlation?
So there's actually a linear correlation between the change in current that I can detect and the protein concentration in your bloodstream.
Was the correlation well established, and the question was, how do you detect that protein efficiently? Or
so
did you also have to try to map that correlation?
So it was to increase the sensitivity of the device. So this device is actually 250 times more sensitive than what's conventionally used.
Right.
So it can detect acute cardiac illness and chronic cardiac illness.
What was the principle that led you to make it so much more efficient?
It's based in nanotechnology, so I can actually maximize and manipulate the large surface area of the carbon nanofibers. They actually look like this, vertically aligned carbon nanofibers, based on which I can actually just latch on linkers and antibodies and antigens to actually detect certain proteins. So the beauty in this device is that it can be used not only for health diagnostics, but also for biowarfare agent detection or food safety monitoring or environmental monitoring.
So just the concept generally, where you've got a correlation that you can establish
exactly.
Using nanotechnology,
exactly.
You can get a more sensitive, more acute,
mm-hmm.
and quicker and ultimately cheaper
mm-hmm.
Technique.
So even cheaper than this is the paper-based sensor. So you can actually touch it if you want to. It's a paper-based sensor. So the idea is something like this could take the form of an insulin test.
Mm-hmm.
So you go to CVS, pick it up, use it, and throw it away.
Right.
And this would be extremely cheap, very economical, and really revolutionize the in-home patient care market.
So this seems like a pretty big deal. So where are we at now in terms of, have you taken what you learned and started to talk to companies that are already in the diagnostic field on this?
So I'm working at NASA Ames, Moffett Field in California. So we're working on that prototyping stage right now,
mm-hmm.
Working on making it into a handheld device so you can actually just test on the go or at home. So we're working on that right now.
Well, and obviously, you're going to continue with your research and ideas in college.
Yes, definitely.
Do you have an idea of what ultimately you'd like to do?
I hope to major in material science and engineering in college and then work as a technology entrepreneur.
Excellent.
In the Valley.
In the Valley?
In the Valley.
Come on, let's take a good picture.
Ready.
Really proud of you.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
So nice to meet you.
Really nice to meet you. That's great.
Thank you.
Fantastic.